We got to talk about James Franklin. And I'm sure that everybody saw this. Apparently, this went down a couple months ago. But he has changed agents. He has gone from Trace Armstrong over to the mega agent, Jimmy Sexton. And along with that, because, of course, that news breaks yesterday or today or whenever it was, that stuff goes on. And then he has a press conference on Tuesday where he is explaining to everybody that, no, no, these other jobs are not the reason why we lost this game. I am fully focused on the job at hand. And this man, in his press conference, misspoke and said that he and his team are focused completely on Illinois and this team and this program. Now, of course, everybody knows that Penn State played Illinois last week, and they play Ohio State this week. And on top of that, he said he slipped and called Ohio Stadium the Big House, which we all know is actually Michigan Stadium. So instead of calling it the Horseshoe, he called it the Big House, and that's a misspeak, and we get that. And the Illinois thing is a misspeak as well. This is a man that is normally very controlled and very on top of things. And in this press conference setting where he is being asked about him looking around at other jobs, he just completely lost it. Do you think that he might be focused on some of these other things outside of football right now?
No, but I do think he's looking at other jobs, okay? But I think you can look at other jobs and still try to do your job well, right? So those two things aren't part and parcel, separated from one another, okay? I think that he is not handling being asked about them because he doesn't know how to lie. He's a very bad liar, and that's a good quality to have, by the way. I think he's uncomfortable, and I will tell you this. I'm gonna turn this around because I don't know. How would you answer these questions if you were actively interested in a job that was open, and you were trying to do the job you were doing? You're not certain you're going to get the job that's open, and so you're constantly being asked about these other jobs. How would you respond every week?
I think the perfect response, we've seen other coaches do this, the perfect response is, I am the coach at Penn State, and I am focused on being the coach at Penn State. It's not a denial. It's not anything else. It is, you don't bring up the other teams. You don't bring up anything that can be misspeak or anything else. You just say, I am focused on this job. I am the coach at Penn State. Period. End of sentence. If something changes with that, obviously you guys will know. But I am the coach at Penn State, and I plan on being the coach at Penn State. I mean, it's very, very simple. You don't have to mention the stadium that you're going to play in. You don't have to mention the team that you're going to play. None of that. Yeah, it's very simple stuff. But I do understand being uncomfortable in a situation if you don't want to be asked about this stuff, right? I don't think anybody would. But I think there's ways that he could handle it. Clay Travis was on The Next Round, which is a new startup show out of Birmingham. It's the guys that used to be on WJOX. And he told him, and he's personal friends with James Franklin from back when Franklin was at Vanderbilt over in Nashville. And he said that he thought this before the season, that Franklin is ready to leave Pennsylvania. Like, he is, it's time. The resources and whatnot that are being put in at Ohio State and at Michigan and other teams in the Big Ten, Penn State is not going to be able to match what they are doing. So his one time of winning the Big Ten, he may not have the resources or the recruiting resources to be able to mimic that again. So my guess is, yes, he is going to look at taking one of these other jobs, whether it's USC or LSU, but he has stated openly in the past that his goal is to be the first black head coach to win a national championship, and I don't know that you can get that done at Penn State. I think you can probably get it done maybe at USC, and you can definitely do it at LSU if you are a good enough head coach. So that's my idea on that. You kind of feel the same?
Completely agree.
All right. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at WinningCures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.